speak French, but you can ask questions in English. So, welcome to the conference about the third Equality Summit. It's a conference being held once a year by the country having the presidency in the autumn. This is Sweden, and next time it will be Belgium in the autumn of 2010. Equality Summit will have participants who are representatives of governments, organizations, companies, and the media. The media have also been invited to this conference to talk about how we can talk about equality and possibilities and opportunities for the citizens of the EU. We have talked of the public sector, the private sector, the various actors who will have to cooperate, and the role of the media. We also have to discuss that in connection with diversity and equality. We have also had workshops, conversations about the situation in Europe and about the Roma situation in particular, because we think those are the groups in society exposed to a lot of discrimination, hatred, discrimination, physical violence, actually, and it's unacceptable. So you are exposed to discrimination of individuals, but we also have member states who do not apply legislation. The police does not want to do what is expected of it. If there is, if there are expressions of hatred, and if often you see that member states omit to react to this. And this conference is very important because we're also discussing the new directive about discrimination, because we want minimum protection for EU citizens. And it shouldn't be important where in the EU you are if you are exposed to discrimination. We have gone through negotiations with very high ambitions. There will be no decision taken during the Swedish presidency, but we will take this forward. We will support it during the Spanish presidency. Now I leave the floor to Commissioner Mr. Spiedle. Do you have anything to add?
Merci beaucoup.
Thank you. Thank you. Last week's Eurobarometer showed us that one European out of six states to have been personally subject to discriminations during the last 12 months, and more than half of the Europeans are worried. They think that the crisis will only increase discriminations. This is an unacceptable situation. In times of crisis, more than ever, we must fight as much as we can discrimination. We must fight against stereotypes and prejudices. We need an inclusive society which is not only richer and more fascinating, but is also a more productive society. In fact, we need everyone's talents to overcome the crisis. It is not the time now to diminish our efforts to have a more inclusive society. We cannot afford to leave to their own destiny entire sections of our society. Furthermore, our societies are aging, and economic recovery now and in the longer term is only possible if we avail ourselves of all our talents and all available experiences. That is why today's meeting is so important. All together, we must double our efforts to eliminate all forms of discrimination. I have made a proposal for a directive in the field of equal treatment last year with this precise objective. European Parliament and the various European committees have welcomed this proposal. It is now being discussed in the Council, and I congratulate the Swedish Presidency for its efforts that have really made progress in the negotiations. I'm really aware of the sensibilities of certain member states, but this is an essential dossier, and that is why I appeal to all member states to make this extra effort in such a way as to be able to adopt the directive next year. Legislation, though, is not all. There are many other ways to combat discriminations and to allow the equality agenda to make progress in the Union. That is why partnerships at all levels are very important, just as today's conference has shown us. Thank you. Thank you to the Swedish Presidency, and all together we must continue working to have a rich European society, rich in its diversity, and an inclusive and tolerant society. Thank you.
And now the floor is open. Do you have questions? And we can also have individual interviews afterwards.
From People's Daily Online, Xu Fei Chen. I just like to know that what is the tangible results you have achieved for this summit, and what do you really expect to achieve?
What do we want to achieve here? Well, on the one hand, we want to point out how important it is to have cooperation between the various actors or stakeholders. And we also look at the role of the media. The media can do good and bad. It depends how aware of this they are when they report on this, because we've talked of media telling the truth, but it is the truth that belongs to the media. Maybe it's not the full truth. And there is also cooperation with NGOs, with politicians. It should be based on knowledge. And we have various NGOs representing interests, focusing on one single type of ground for discrimination. And I think they should meet. I think that discrimination should be seen in under multiple angles, because if we have a diverse Europe, we should also ask ourselves, why should I be discriminated against? Is it because I'm a woman, I'm black, I'm young, I'm old, or is there something wrong with me? And I think that we should not accept that individuals are accepted to discrimination. It should be something that the various authorities should be able to assess. Is this discrimination because of one thing or various grounds? And I think we can only develop this if we cooperate. The ambition was also to focus on the situation of various types, in particular the Roma. We cannot exclude groups of society from anything. We have to focus on equal opportunities for all human beings. But we have to live up to this. Words are not enough. We have to work actively as politicians, but also involve other actors so that they will also cooperate. And in this conference where we're interacting with different actors, we should form the basis of discrimination work to be taken forward. Multifaceted, diverse discrimination should be looked at. Thank you.
Inga ytterligare frågor?
Any other questions? Then we'll take the interviews then, individual interviews.